Hello, I'm Kairanu from Physiology Department, School of Medical Sciences, University Science Malaysia. In this video, we are going to talk about respiratory adjustment during exercise. During exercise, the exercising muscles have a high oxygen demand, and from increased tissue metabolism, there is increased carbon dioxide production. To get more oxygen and to get rid of the carbon dioxide, the alveolar ventilation increased. The stimulus for the increased ventilation comes from the proprioceptors of the muscles and joints. These proprioceptors send information to the medullary inspiratory center, which commands to increase ventilation. Because of the increased ventilation, more oxygen enters the capillary and carbon dioxide is leaving, you would expect the arterial pressure of oxygen to increase and carbon dioxide to decrease. However, this do not happen. The arterial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide remains unchanged during exercise. The scientific reason behind this has not been elucidated yet. It is still a mystery how the ventilation rate can be altered so precisely to meet the increased demand that the arterial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide does not change during exercise. This is arterial. In venous, the increased carbon dioxide produced from tissue metabolism increases the venous pressure of carbon dioxide. So, arterial oxygen and carbon dioxide do not change, while venous carbon dioxide increased. The excess carbon dioxide is cleared by increased ventilation rate, so the excess carbon dioxide never reaches the systemic arterial blood. Now, what about pH? During moderate exercise, arterial pH does not change, but during strenuous exercise, the arterial pH may decrease because the exercising muscles produce lactic acid. To meet the increased oxygen demand, cardiac output increased. The cardiac output from the right heart increased the pulmonary blood flow. There is a decrease in pulmonary resistance and more pulmonary capillary beds are perfused, which also improves the efficiency of gas exchange. As a result, pulmonary blood flow becomes more evenly distributed throughout the lungs. The ventilation perfusion ratio is normally uneven in the upright lungs. It is usually higher at the apex and lower at the base. Because of pulmonary blood flow becomes more even, the VQ ratio also becomes more uniform, producing a decrease in physiologic dead space. So, the exercising muscles are producing more carbon dioxide, more lactic acid, which reduces the pH and increases temperature. All of this shifts the oxygen hemoglobin curve to the right. The P50 increase and hemoglobin affinity for oxygen decrease, making it easier to unload oxygen in the exercising skeletal muscle. The exercising skeletal muscle have high oxygen demand, so the oxygen demand is matched by shifting the oxygen hemoglobin curve to the right. So, in summary, exercise will lead to increased oxygen consumption, increased carbon dioxide production, and increased ventilation. In the arterial blood, the pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide do not change, whereas pH also do not change in moderate exercise, but decrease in strenuous exercise. Venous pressure of carbon dioxide increase because of increased tissue metabolism. With regards to pulmonary blood flow, the cardiac output increase. This also increases the pulmonary blood flow, which then results more even VQ ratio throughout the lungs and reduce the physiologic dead space. Exercise will also shift the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve to the right, which increase the P50 and reduce hemoglobin affinity for oxygen and making it easier for oxygen to be unloaded to the tissues to meet the higher oxygen demand. That's all for the respiratory adjustment during exercise. Thank you for watching.